Hey, it's me, Destin. Welcome back to Smarter Every Day. I was asked if I wanted to make a video about global health issues. Now, here's the deal. When you think about, let's make a video about global health issues, you think about statistics and numbers and like money, or you think about your sister who served in the Peace Corps in Sub-Saharan Africa, where over 90% of all malaria cases happen, where she got malaria. Today on Smarter Every Day, I want to just rewind the clock and go take you on a trip that I went on to go visit her in Sub-Saharan Africa, and then we'll just ask her what it was like to get malaria. Sounds like a fun video. Let's do it. All right, story time. Several years ago, my friend Steve-O and my sister Reagan were both stationed with the Peace Corps in West Africa. I decided to go visit them and check up and see what their efforts were like. I flew to Dakar, Senegal, where Steve-O met me, and we traveled to the Gambia via setplas, which is a word that means a car with seven seats in it. We were all crammed in there, and it was really cool going across the desert like that, but we traveled all the way to a city called Farafini in the Gambia, where Steve-O was stationed as a Peace Corps volunteer and computer scientist. He was working with local organizations to try to help them figure out computerized records keeping and even simple stuff like how to get printers to work. I, of course, wanted to contribute by teaching math and science, so I managed to get some model rockets into the country so Steve-O and I could have a local, I don't know, rocket workshop, you could call it, with the kids. They were super excited and everything worked out perfect. Anyway, while staying with Steve-O at his hut, every night I slept in a hammock under a mosquito net. This was there to prevent me from getting malaria. Just on the other side of the reed fence for me was Steve-O's host brother, Modu. He's a hilarious guy and we love to drink tea with each other and play Scrabble. We had a lot of fun together, but one day, Steve-O agreed to take me to see what Modu did for a day job. He worked at the local health clinic where I got to see the front lines of what the battle against malaria looked like. These guys had microscopes that were just like mine at my house, but they were set up in this really small room where sanitation was a challenge because they had limited supplies. But anyway, they were doing the best they could with what they had. They were staining the blood and then looking at it under the microscope to try to see what blood cells had malaria in it. I didn't have a very good camera at the time, so I came home, bought these human pathogen slides, and then we are sitting here using the same type microscope looking at malaria. And what does it look like?
Malaria?
Yeah.
It looks like when you look at a blood smear, you see a ton of red blood cells. Well, malaria looks like an enlarged red blood cell with a darkened stain. So when the malaria gets inside of the red blood cell, the erythrocyte, it can sometimes look like a white blood cell because it's an enlarged donut that has spots in it, darkened spots.
So that's how it works. It gets bigger and then eventually blows the red blood cell up from the inside out.
I would assume so.
Okay, I'll be honest. I had to research how malaria works. It's like this. Malaria is caused by a parasite that lives inside of mosquitoes who've previously taken a blood meal from another human. We know that part, right? This is the part I didn't know. When the mosquito bites the next person, they release this parasite called the sporozoites into the human's bloodstream, which then makes its way to the person's liver cells. The incubation period in the liver cells is anywhere between 7 and 30 days, and in that time it starts to consume those cells and transform into the next phase called the merozoites, where it will multiply until the liver cells explode. Once they explode, it makes its way to the other red blood cells and then starts to repeat the process by multiplying until those red blood cells explode, and then pretty much the whole immune system's out of whack. You've got fever, chills, headaches, nausea, vomiting, body aches. It's bad. Severe cases of malaria can cause a coma, seizures, kidney failures, or even death. It's a really big deal, so obviously Modu's efforts in this clinic were super important. If you can diagnose malaria quickly, you can treat it. After finishing our visit in Farafini, we traveled via setplas back to Banjul, the capital of the Gambia, where we caught a flight down to Freetown, Sierra Leone, which is the capital city. My sister Reagan met us there, and then we traveled overland via taxi to her village, which was called Mano. My sister taught at a secondary school, so Steve-O and I jumped in and helped where we could, teaching math to the students. Playtime at the village was really fun. I got to play with the kids and show them all these different types of flying toys that I'd brought with me, but one day, The locals decided to come take me and Steve-O to a local swimming hole. There were ladies that were mining for gold there. We learned how to fish with nets, but I noticed something in the water.
It's pretty neat. There's a bunch of rocks all around, and on that far side there's some rapids. But when the water goes down during the dry season, you have these individual puddles that form. This one appears to have some larvae in it and some kind of animal in each one. I have no idea what it is. They look like worms.
In the back of my mind, I thought these might be mosquito eggs, but I didn't really know. I came home and researched and found this video from the 1940s, which shows that mosquitoes lay eggs in these little bitty rafts. The eggs then hatch and later become larvae, which then turn into pupa. After a couple of days, when it's fully developed, it takes in air and then swells and splits the pupal skin and ejects itself. It's really kind of freaky, actually. The males are typically vegetarians, while the females seek out blood and drink it whenever they can get it. Anyway, apparently a female mosquito got a hold of my sister because at some point during her time in Africa, she got malaria.
My sister likes to travel. We're taking her to the airport right now. She's going to Colombia. But when you were in Sierra Leone, you got malaria, right?
I did.
What was it like?
It was tiring. I basically had a fever, which I don't remember having a fever ever before, that moment, but chills, sweating. I had to take a blood drop test, an immediate test for malaria, and I tested positive, and then I had to travel to the capital city, and I basically slept for 3 days.
Okay, if you watch the news, you're gonna hear that everything's getting worse, right? It's not. The world is getting better, and there's reasons to be optimistic. Malaria research is one of those things. Over the last 15 years, the amount of money poured into malaria research has gone up tenfold, resulting in a 60% decrease in mortality due to malaria. My sister being one of those hundreds of thousands of people that didn't die that would have died 15 years ago. That's a really big deal. Of course, the goal is zero deaths due to malaria, but hey, we're on the right trend. We need to be optimistic. Not just from malaria, but in general, 122 million children have been saved by these efforts since the 90s. If you look at the data collected by the Institute of Health Metrics and Evaluation, childhood mortality rate across the board has decreased from 12.1 million deaths in 1990. Anyway, if this video added any value to your life at all, please consider subscribing and hitting the bell to be notified next time Smarter Every Day uploads. If not, that's no big deal. Please check out the Gates annual letter. It's really interesting. I mean, these people have a strategy and they're going to execute on the strategy. And the result of that is thousands of people not dying. That's cool. It's worth reading the letter. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this. I'm Destin. You're getting smarter every day. Have a good one.
Have fun in Colombia. Don't get Zika or malaria.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye.